Hey all YouTubers! Today I have a tiny celebration as I've recently reached 5,000 subscribers. I didn't even know whether there was 5,000 people that work with Twinka 3 on planet Earth, let alone that would be interested in a Twinka 3 related YouTube channel. PLC programming in general and Twinka 3 programming in particular is just such a narrow subject that I never thought I would even pass the 1,000 subscribers mark. And now that I'm at 5,000, it feels... well, I'm very happy. It's, of course, very motivating when the number of subscribers just keep growing, and it motivates me to do even more content that can be shared. Most of you already know my standpoint about the automation industry. The industry is not used to share knowledge openly, and it's locked in a situation where only a very few benefit from having it this way. I have so much I want to share. If I could just snap my fingers and transfer all my knowledge I have about PLC programming to you instantly, I wouldn't hesitate. I don't see any sense in keeping any information for myself. Now that I've been running this channel for a while, I have, however, unfortunately discovered it's a massive time investment in running it. That's why I've decided to work a little less on my day-to-day job and put a little more effort in this channel. I thought I'd go through some of the most common questions I got here on a piece of paper. The overwhelmingly most common question lately is regarding monetization. So, why don't you put your Twinka 3 course on Udemy? Why not Udemy? You can make money. How much money does F.A.Q pay you? And there's related questions like, are you a communist? And I unfortunately get quite a few angry and mean emails. I don't know why people have gotten so locked up regarding payment. I will not publish this Twinka 3 PLC programming tutorial on Udemy or any other site where there is a paywall, and I don't receive any money from F.A.Q. Zero. My ambition is to keep this channel free and open. This is one of the challenges of industrial automation, that we have to start sharing our knowledge more openly and not put everything behind paywalls. This is what I encourage also my viewers to do. If it's so important that I get money, you can contribute with a few cents by becoming a YouTube or Patreon member of this channel, but that's optional, and I will publish the rest of this tutorial for free here on YouTube. So, another question I get quite commonly is a request to do a course or tutorial for the product X, Y, or Z. So, for example, motion control or Twinkat HMI or Twinkat C++, etc., etc. So, while I do plan to continue creating content on this channel, also after that the PLC tutorial is finished, I can't promise I will be able to create tutorials for every request, and the simple reason is time. So far, I have a full-time job, and everything I'm doing here is done on my spare time. Doing a single episode of the Twinka 3 course takes anywhere between 20 and 60 hours. So it's a full-time job after work and on weekends, holidays and vacations. I'm not saying that I don't want you to request stuff. I want you to do that, so I know what people want. But I just want you to have realistic expectations of how much content I can actually produce. Okay, and the next question is regarding structured text versus ladder. So the question is basically, why do I do structured text and not ladder? Can I do ladder instead of structured text? And the answer to this question is simple. It's a big no. Without getting too political, I think ladder is a dead end. I could rant about this for an hour, so I'll give you a long answer in a separate video. For now, I'll just say that I will never make any tutorial or any content on this channel regarding ladder or any other of the other graphical languages for that matter. I will only use structured text and possibly some traditional programming languages such as C#, C++, or Python. So the final question I got is if I have time to chat about Twinkat and help with a specific problem. And I get quite a lot of these questions and requests, and I'm not able to help each and one of my viewers. But what I have decided is to do a live coding session. So I'm still working on the details of this and exactly how everything is gonna play out. But the current plan is to do a live streaming session here on YouTube where I will solve a specific problem. I will post more updates regarding this here on my YouTube channel, so make sure to subscribe to receive notifications about this. I want to finish by saying thank you to every single one of my viewers. It's thanks to you that this channel exists. If I had no viewers, I would not create any content. So thanks for helping me reach this milestone. I hope that I will be able to provide valuable content to you for as long as possible and that you will continue to watch my videos. Okay, I will finish this video by opening one of these party poppers so I can spend the rest of the day vacuum cleaning this room. And yeah, So let's go. Whee! Bye-bye.